Hello friends, I welcome you to my channel Dev's Institute. Today we will see 8051 microcontroller addition program. Before starting to lecture, I will request you to subscribe to my channel by clicking subscribe button and click on bell icon to get instant notification when I add new videos to the channel. Problem statement. Write 8051 assembly language program to add 5 8-bit numbers stored in internal RAM location and store result in R6 and R7 register. 8051 is 8-bit microcontroller, that means every memory location stores the 8-bit data and memory location address is 16-bit. This is the program for adding 5 8-bit numbers using 8051 microcontroller. Now we will see its execution step by step. First instruction is move R1,05 hex. This will move number 05 to register R1. Before that, let us consider that the number which we want to add are stored at memory location D000 to D004. These are 5 numbers 1, 2, 3, 4 and 6 which we want to add. Okay. First instruction is move R1,05. Hash means it is the hexadecimal number, and by this instruction number 5 will be moved to register R1. So R1 register contain value 05. Next instruction is move DPTR,D000H. DPTR is the data pointer register which is of 16-bit. All other registers in 8051 microcontroller are of 8-bit and this DPTR is of 16-bit. That means that DPTR can store 16-bit value. As the memory addresses in 8051 microcontroller are 16-bit, we use this register, data pointer register, to store the address of the location. So by this instruction, DPTR will be initialized to D000H. Next instruction is move R6,00. So we are initializing register R6 by 00. Next instruction is move R7,00. We are initializing R7 by 00. We are going to store result in R6 and R7. We are going to store result in R6 and carry in R7 register. Next instruction is move XA,DPTR. Now here A is the accumulator register and DPTR is this data pointer. But when we attach this DPTR means value stored at the address which is present in DPTR register. Okay, so here in this instruction move AX, because we are now moving from memory location address to the accumulator. When we have to move from one register to another register like this, move R6,A. Here R6 is also register, A is also register. We are moving contents from register A to register R6. So here we use just move, but here we are moving data from D000 location to accumulator. That's why we use move X. Move X is used to transfer data from memory address to the register location. And memory address here is specified by DPTR register. One more thing, here we give label as back. So if you are using a microcontroller kit and you are entering this code on a kit, So at the time of coding, you must note down the memory address for this instruction, because this whenever later in the instruction, whenever we are going to use jump to back, then at that time instead of this back, you have to give address of this instruction. So let's say if this is, we are starting or we are writing program at C000 location, then this instruction comes at approximately C009. So C009 we are going to write somewhere, and at this time at the time of writing of this instruction, we will use DJNZ R1, C009. So instead of this back label, we are going to use the address of this instruction. Okay, so this instruction is MOVX A@DPTR. By this instruction @DPTR, so DPTR contains D000, value at T00 is 01, so 01 will be transferred to accumulator. Then next instruction is ADD A R6. By this instruction, contents of accumulator and contents of R6 register will be added and result will be stored in accumulator. That means here this instruction performs A = A+R6. So contents of A and R6 are added and result will be stored in register A. So now contents of R6 are 0 and A is 1. So 0 plus 1 is 1. So after this instruction, contents of A will be 1 and carry flag is 0 as carry is not generated. Next instruction is MOV R6, A. By this instruction, contents of A will be transferred to R6. So after this instruction, contents of R6 will be 1, because we are moving this 1 to R6. Next instruction is MOV A, R7. That means now this is about the addition and now we have to deal with the carry. So here MOV A, R7, we are moving previous carry. Now this is the first digit, so no, not carry is generated at this point. So R7 is, we are moving A, R7. So this R700 will be moved to A. ADD C A, 00. Add C means add carry A, 00, means add carry plus A plus 0 and result will be stored in A. So now here carry is 0, contents of accumulator are 0 and this is 0. So 0 plus 0 plus 0, so result, finally result is 0. So A is 0, carry is 0. Next, MOV R7, A. A is 0, no carry is generated at this point. So this same contents will be moved to R7. R7 is 0. INC DPTR, that means increment DPTR. DPTR will be incremented by 1 and now DPTR will become D001. Next instruction, DJNZ, decrement and jump if not 0 R1, back, means decrement R1 by 1. Decrement, first operation performed is decrement, yes, R1 is decremented by 1, and jump if not 0, yes, R1 is not 0, so jump if not 0 to back. So where is the back? This back, at this instruction. So here you have to give the address of instruction which is labeled as back. Okay, so it will jump here. Next instruction is MOVX A, DPTR. So now DPTR contains value D001. So D001 @DPTR means contents of D001, 02 02 will be moved to accumulator 02. Next instruction, add A, R6. Now we have previous addition 1 here in R6. So now add A, R6. So 1 plus 2, result will be 3. Result will be stored in accumulator. 3, carry flag is not set because carry is not generated by this operation. Next instruction, move R6, A. This 03 will be moved to R6. Move A, R7 again to deal with carry. This R7 will be moved here 00, carry 0. So this operation makes accumulator 0. Add carry, no carry is there. A is also 0 and 0. So accumulator is 0 and we are moving this A to R7. So R7 is also 0. Next instruction is increment DPTR. DPTR will be D002. Decrement and jump if not 0, R1, back. R1 is decremented by 1, it will become 3. It is not a 0, so it will jump to back. Now, again, move XA, DPTR. Now, DPTR contains D002. D002 at the rate D002 means the value at D002 is 03. So 03 will be transferred to accumulator. Add A, R6. Now R6 contains 3, accumulator contains 3. 3 plus 3 result is 6. So add A, R6 will result in value 6 in A. Then move A, R6. So we are moving this content of A to R6. So content of AR6 will be moved to R6. So R6 will become 6. Again, move A, R7. R7 is 0 and again carry flag was not generated by 3 plus 3 operation. So R7 is 0, A is 0, carry flag is 0. So move A, R7. Add CA00, move R7, A. So all these 3 will be 0. Increment DPTR. DPTR will be D003. Decrement jump if not 0, R1, back. R1 will become 2 and as it is not 0, again control will be transferred to this instruction. Move XA, DPTR. Now, DPTR contains D003. D003, data at D03 is 04. So, 04 will be moved to accumulator. Next instruction, add A, R6. Now, R6 contains 6. Value at accumulator is 4. 6 plus 4 is 08. This is hexadecimal addition. 6 plus 4 is 08. So result will be stored in accumulator. Next instruction, move R6, A. So now at this point accumulator contains A, that A will be transferred to R6. R6 will contain A. Move A, R7 to deal with carry. Again, this instruction add this addition doesn't generate any carry flag. So R7 is 00, A is 0, carry flag is 0. So these 3 instructions will make R7 0, A 0 and carry flag 0. Next is increment DPTR. DPTR will now contain D004. Decrement jump if not 0, R1, back. R1 will be decremented by 1, it will become 1. It is still not 0, so it will control will come at this location. Move XA, DPTR. Now DPTR contains address D004. So D004, value at D004 is 06. 06 will be transferred here. Then add A, R6. Now see here, contents of R6 is A, and contents of A is 06. A plus 06, if you do hexadecimal addition, then addition is 10. 10 means result is 0 and carry is 1. So at this point, when this instruction is executed, add A comma R6, contents of A and R6 are added, that means A plus 06, result will be stored in accumulator and carry flag is set if carry is generated. So as we just discussed, A plus 6 is 10, that means result is 0 and carry is 1. Now move R6 comma A. So whatever is this result, we are moving it to R6 register. R6 is 0. Move A comma R7. Now previously no carry was generated, so R7 is still 0. We are moving this 0 to accumulator A. Now add carry, add with carry A comma 00. So A plus 00 is 00 and plus carry. Now here carry is 1. So 00 plus 00 plus 1, result is 1. So now A will contain 1, which is nothing but a carry. Move R7 comma A. Now we are moving this carry to R7. Increment DPTR. DPTR will point to D005. Decrement and jump if not 0, R1 to back. So now R1 will be decremented by 1. It will become 00. So now it means that we have added all the 5 numbers and control will be transferred to the next instruction. Now here we are getting final result in R6 and R7 register. R6 contains final result and R7 contains the carry. So our final result is 10 hex, where 0 is the result, 1 is the carry. 10 hex. And result is present in R6 and R7. Now suppose we want to transfer this result or we want to store this result in the memory. So to store this result in the memory, we use next instructions. Move DPTR comma D005. Now suppose we want to store result in D005 and D006. Okay, so we must copy this memory address to DPTR. So move DPTR comma hash D005. So DPTR will contain address D005. Move A comma R6. So contents of R6, which is nothing but our result, will be copied to accumulator. Because see, we cannot transfer directly from R6 to memory location. From R6 to memory location directly is not possible. To transfer any contents to memory location, we must transfer it to the accumulator, and from accumulator we can transfer it to the memory location. Next instruction is move X at the rate DPTR comma A. Again, we are moving content to memory location. That's why we are using move X. If it is just between the register, we can use only move, but here we are moving it to memory location, that's why we are using move X. So this 0 will be moved to D005. Okay. Next, this is move DPTR comma hash D006. That means we have to move this R7 to the D006. So that's why DPTR is contains D006. Move A comma R7. So this R7 will be moved to accumulator, and move X at the rate DPTR comma A. So this A will be moved to D006 location. This is all about how addition program is written using 8051 microcontroller. Thank you so much for watching this video. If you like my video, please press like button given below the video. You can ask me your queries through comment section. And don't forget to subscribe to my channel and click on the bell icon to get notifications about the latest video uploads. Thank you. Thank you very much.